What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Minecraft server. So I should have recorded, but I was actually talking with Doc M and Justify in the middle of the night, and I figured, you know what, I'm just gonna get this done here. So I don't know if I want if this is complete and whether or not I want this to be complete. Well, I want it complete, but I don't know if it's like how I want it. It looks good. I'll give it that. And I know I'm staying still here for a second, guys. So basically, this is what I have here for you guys. As you guys can see, that is a lot of mossy cobble, but there's a lot of spawners. And I actually had to borrow 2 stacks from Packrat from his little place there. So if I find spawners, I'm gonna have to definitely pay him back. But I definitely feel that this adds a lot of character to it already. And I'm not too sure. I said I was gonna probably add like 4, but I think those 2 themselves is good enough. And one thing that pisses me off is, if you guys take a look, I didn't measure this correctly, is if you guys take a look, there's no space here, right? And I thought I had this centered here, but there's a space here, and that is gonna irk me so freaking much. But I think it's time. I gotta say goodbye to this place, and I'm gonna go traveling, and I know it's not gonna make for the best like footage in that, but I'm gonna bring some stuff with me. I gotta make sure that some frame rate issues. Whoa! Frames, why are you being all issuey? That doesn't make any sense. Okay, so first of all, I'd like to thank everyone for, wishing me the best and all that, for going to the doctor and everything. I actually did go there. I got my blood taken again because they said that my enzyme count is really, really high. And he explained it, but it didn't really make much sense to me. He said that, where am I pick? Or where is my fortune pick? What the fudge? Okay, there it is. And obviously I'm not, oh, you know what? I'm gonna have to quickly do something here. I'm getting frame rate issues like a boss. Okay, I'm hoping that did that. Really, kitty? I just got finished fixing this and now you just wanna bother me? You're a butthole. Okay, I'm just taking a look on whether or not I want to bring some stuff here. Bring some coal so I don't have to mine that. I think I'm good on everything else. I don't really want to bring too much here. You know what? We'll bring some of the melons. Yeah, we'll bring a stack. That way we don't have to really work on a wheat farm. And again, guys, this isn't like a permanent goodbye. I just need a home away from home, and you guys are gonna come along for the trip here while I give some talk to you guys. I'm wondering if I should bring a. You know what I'm going to? I'm gonna bring a quick bed because I don't want to fuck myself up by dying and then having to be all the way over here. Cause that would. Oh, hello, zombie. 3, 1, 2, 3. Perfect. So much, and there we go. 1, 2, 3. So I got a couple things to talk about today. It's gonna be a busy day. It's gonna be a long, well, not long, but it'll be a good day. It'll be a good day. So one of the first things I want to talk to you, well, I guess I should go back and actually say what I was going to say to you guys was that. So I got a bit more information on as to what the heck is going on with my liver. So apparently, like I was saying, that he did 1 blood test. He said that there's 1 anomaly with my one of the enzymes there, and typically that's not too bad. But with this one, I guess what he said was what he's more concerned about was apparently this enzyme. It's supposed to be like ranging from what is it from 5. Or 9 to 50 is the average that that enzyme is okay to be with. We're gonna have to sleep right away. Lovely. But apparently the first time he took the blood test, it was up to 70. So, you know, that was about like 20 levels above. And I'm not too sure what these levels are. I was a bit confused. But at the same time, I kind of, not really understood. But, you know, I understand where he's coming from. We'll say that. You know what? We're going to continue. Oh, I don't even know where to go. I think I'm just going to go this way. I'm just going to go straight. But, so that's why he called me in for the second time, or the first time there. And he just wanted to make sure that, because, you know, tests sometimes go a bit awry, and they fudge up sometimes, so that's why they do more than one. You know, cut once. Don't cut once. Measure after. You're supposed to measure twice and then cut. But, apparently, when I came in, I feel a sneeze, and my girlfriend coughing in the background. Awesome! Yes, makes a great video. Now she's recovering from a cold, so you may hear her cough. Typically, she's not that rude. She doesn't like to cough in your ears. But where the heck was I? Right. So he brought me in the second time. I got my blood taken again, and that's when I got called in to talk what the heck is up. And apparently, since the first blood test, like I said, it was at 70, or I don't even know what the levels mean again, he said that it jumped up to 108. Now, I had to go take more blood, and this time I got like a little bit more taken, because what he said is he wants to test my blood, or test the enzyme, and make sure that it's not like an infection of the liver, such as like Hep A, he said, and that scared me. But the thing about Hep A is it's treatable, so that's good, and I'm kind of relieved about that. I don't understand how I'd get Hep A, because I don't know anyone that has it, but I think I used to work in a beer place, and you know, I've cut my hand on glass there, and I've also worked with empties before, and that might be a possible way to contract that. But again, he said, like, he never said I have it, which is totally different. He also said that, you know, if the tests come back and my enzymes haven't gone down to their normal level, that I need to get my liver ultrasounded to see what the heck is up. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm fudging nervous. I know I shouldn't be. If it was more life-threatening than that, he'd definitely be doing a lot more, but I don't know. I don't deal well with medical issues. I always stress out about it, and like I said, I'm a bit of a hypochondriac, and I always worry myself half to death most of the time just thinking about this stuff. So, you know, let's all stay positive here. And I know you guys were all wishing me the best, and I appreciate it. I was getting messages all day on Twitter, and as well as on my my video and everything, and you guys are awesome for keeping my spirits up. And so let's go on to better news. So a lot of you guys are, I don't know how many of you guys actually watched the AAA Mondays video with Andrea and myself. One of the question there was, you know, if we could create a game, what would we create? And I said something, I was talking about like RPG aspect of like zombie and open world and all this, and a lot of people suggested me Project Zomboid. And it's Project Zomboid, right? I'm just checking out. Yeah, I was just making sure I was calling it by the proper name, because I'd be a huge dumbass if that were the case. But I actually decided to message the guys, and you know, I asked if I could have permission to put up videos on my channel and all that, so I have rights for it. Now the question is, would you guys actually be interested in watching me play that? Because I'm always wary about putting up videos, because you know, some people, they really like this stuff, but at the same time, some people will only watch the very first episode, like it, and then, of course, the second episode will have a few more like, or a few less likes, then the third episode, it'll just tank, and it'll stay around that. I don't know what it is about that, but it's just like, it's hard to keep your guys' attention, you know, it's hard to retain that. But, I want your guys' honest opinion, whether or not you guys would like to watch, a Let's Play on Project Zomboid. I know that, I'm pretty sure there's quite a few people who do it, but I'd be interested in it. It looks pretty cool from what I saw there. And again, I just want your guys' honest opinion. Don't worry, I'm not gonna be mad if you guys say no. I wouldn't be asking if you guys if I didn't want your questions there. No, questions, answers. So, like I said, I went ahead and I got permission to do that. So, if you guys are more than willing to watch it, then I'd be more than willing to play it for you guys, because I'm always willing to play games. And it's always hard for me to do, like, Let's Plays and that, because, you know, it's always, like, is it worth it? Because sometimes I'm worried about, like, getting, like, copyright strikes and that. Well, not, like, copyright strikes, like, third-party copyright warnings, basically, where they say it doesn't affect your account status, but what it does is it actually, come on, think of the name. They put ads on it, and those ads actually go towards the third-party company. I've had that happen with The Walking Dead, and you know, I don't always make videos just for like money or that, and I've never fully went into this just for the money, but yeah, I'm always worried about getting in trouble, and just because I'm not like signed up with anyone like Machinima or the Game Station or, you know, IGN or anything, any of those big guys. But yeah, definitely let me know what you guys would like to think, are whether or not you guys would like to see that. I'm going to go on to a totally different topic. And speed of games, I'm going to be posting a video a couple hours after this one. It's actually Guta myself, and we actually played Sniper Elite V2. Amazing game. Amazing game. However, there was some flaws to it, and a lot of it was SMP. And I know this is going to be so boring. You know what? I'm going to get to some land before I do this. I'll talk with you guys in just a second here. Here we go! Boom! There we go. Land, alas. So, like I was saying there, Sniper Elite V2, so definitely check that out. It was quite fun, and it was actually a bit awkward at first, because I've never played a game with Gude, like, one-on-one. So that was, it was strange, but, you know, I eased into it very well. I'm more, as you guys are probably more aware, I do play a lot with, like, Beef, and, whenever I'm not recording in that, badge, and I will usually play Blur. Goo's just a really busy guy, and, you know, he said he wanted to play V2, or Sniper, and Sniper Elite V2, god dang it! Just say the freaking name properly. And, you know, I looked at it a while back, and I was interested in the co-op, but I didn't know that he bought that until he told me, and I asked whether or not he'd be interested in a co-op, and we decided to check it out, see whether or not it'd actually be the main story, and if it was the main story and it was co-op, we'd definitely do it together. So it was, and it was awesome, and be sure to check that out. And now, the topic that I've been wanting to discuss ever since yesterday. As most of you guys are aware now, if you guys haven't seen the Ultra Hardcore finale, the rest of the video is going to be spoilers, so I'd highly suggest, if you guys haven't watched it, to either A, stop watching it, and then, wait, nope, there's only one option, stop watching, go watch the Ultra Hardcore, and then come back. That's option A. There's no option B or C, okay? So, I've been getting a lot of flack, and I'm not too sure whether or not it's just like mob mentality of people, but I don't understand it. People seem to just shit on my chest, whether or not, you know, there's a couple factors in this that I'll go into, and people, I don't know, I was reading some really harsh comments, and I typically don't let comments get to me. I actually tend to ignore those comments now. And or if people are saying, like, I'm a shit face and don't deserve, I tell them I love them too, and then people will just typically bounce on them, and it'll get voted with too many negative comments, and it won't be shown anymore, which I approve. But, it's weird, because I like to read the Reddit comments, but they've been getting to me as well, and I know I'm probably going to get a lot of flack for this, but I feel like I should speak my mind as well in this. Because I know we're all entitled to our own opinion, right? So don't hate on me for this. I don't hate on you guys for this. But just something that gets a little bit irritating. And I feel I should speak my mind on my side of the story. Now, a lot of people were saying that what I did was unfair. And it was rather cheap to Etho by saying, no, I don't have any dogs. Now, the way I look at that is, why would I give my tactic away? Why would I tell him what exactly I have, what I'm doing, and what I plan on doing. It doesn't make any sense. We both are in this to have fun, but we're also both in it to win, right? And neither of us were angry. He wasn't angry, and I told him after we were recording, it was so hard to lie through my teeth to him, and because, you know, it's hard to just like to say, no, I don't have any wools. I typically laugh whenever I lie about stupid stuff like that, so. But the way I look at it, it's, people could get mad, but the sheer fact is, my wolves didn't do anything. And as well as, like I said, I don't want to give my tactics away. It'd be like, okay, Etho, I know how some people react to bows. I know they either go A, to the right, or to the left. So I shoot a little bit ahead of that. No, you don't do that. You keep that stuff to yourself. You keep your secrets to yourself. You keep what you know how you're going to win to yourself, and you don't tell anyone. It's a tactic. It's battle. It's what it is. It wasn't cheap to me for me to lie. I went in, and I was fully prepared to get like bombarded with like hate comments. But people seem to be taking it a bit too far. Like I was talking with like a couple of the guys, and I don't understand it. Like, a lot of you guys know that Etho and I are actually, well, I'd like to think we're good friends, right? Because, you know, we're always like constantly recording Dwarves vs. Zombies. He's always on late at night on the server, and I am as well. And, you know, just because, and I'm not saying this because I won or anything, but like, you know, just because I won, I don't think I really deserve all the dislikes on it. It's a bit silly. You know, I don't know. If I'd be saying the exact same thing if, say, like, Beef or Goot or B00 or them won against Etho and they got, like, bombarded with hate comments and all that. You know, it's unacceptable. Like, we're all friends. We all go into this as friends. We all come out as friends. And, you know, it should really go down the route where we get hated on just for playing the game that the way it's intended. But, another thing that kind of bothered me. And I was reading, and I know it shouldn't bother me, but it's always the whole, they got lucky. And I was reading like, oh, if Etho got a couple hits in at the start, he would have won. But that's the thing, he didn't. And I'm not saying this to brag or anything. I'm saying it's all PvP, it's all skill-based in this. Don't get me wrong! Do not get me wrong! I'm not saying Etho isn't skilled, I'm just saying that, you know, I've played a lot of games that require like PvP. I played a lot of World of Warcraft. I got I forget what rank I got in, but like basically back in Vanilla WoW, there was like a ranking system. I actually got a couple ranks in there. I wasn't like high, but I mean like I knew what I was doing. I also play a lot of Call of Duty, which is where my sniping comes from. I played, I'm ashamed to say it, but I played over 900 hours in Call of Duty 2 on PC. So I'm kind of used to sniping with the mouse, which is why I'm not afraid to admit I'm beast with the bow. When that's exactly why I'm pretty decent with the bow in my opinion. But yeah, I don't know. It's just like, I don't know. People seem to think it's all luck based when realistically we have these things planned out. If we get bombarded, we have to quickly react, like the way Goud reacted. Like when Zisto bombarded him, he drew a couple arrows, which greatly, greatly increased Goud's chance to live. But it still, in the end, became his demise, and he perished because of it. Wow, what the heck am I saying? I'm using big old adult words here. Whoa, what the fuck? Ah! Watch. Yeah, there's a cactus there. Stupid cacti. But I don't know. I know I shouldn't really let these comments get to me. I do have fun, and regardless of the comments, I'm always going to have fun. And I'm always doing these videos for the people who support me, and, you know, for the haters who are going to hate just for purely hating, go fuck yourself. I couldn't care less. I'm not going to stop doing YouTube videos in the end just because of a couple hate comments here or there. And I don't think any of us will. And like I said, we're all friends. We all go into this as friends. We all come out as friends. And typically at the end, we always stay in and we talk for like an hour at like all the funny stuff and the stupid stuff we derped up on. And I don't know. I think that should be enough for my ultra hardcore rant. But I felt there's some stuff to be said there. And I hope that you guys take I don't know. You guys go in the next videos or the next season or a couple seasons with a different mindset and be just think before you say, "Ooh, let's see if they're ooh, I want to see if this guy has anything. You got anything, mate?" Oh my god. Ooh, these guys actually you have the robes out here. After one at my area, you don't. You jerk. Hello. Just coming to steal. I'll take the apples. You can keep the iron pick. Okay, sorry. Peace! But, I felt like I rambled on a bit here. again, just to reiterate, think before you say, we're all friends. We don't hate one another. We all talk on a daily basis. This is a huge friggin' place. This is actually really nice. Testificate! Run! No! You leave him alone! You son of a bitch. You're okay. You're okay. Yeah, yeah, you. Kid that zombie, okay? Peace. But yeah, just to reiterate, again, mindset, we're all friends, all that stupid mumbo jumbo I just went in and said. And again, I'm fully aware I'm probably gonna get like flamed, and I don't care. I'm entitled to my own opinion, and I know you guys are as well, which is why I never said anyone's name or anything. And yeah, let me know what you guys, if you guys would like to see Project Zomboid, and be on the lookout for Sniper Elite V2. And I'll be traveling for a couple more days here when I come back to recording. All right, guys, I really hope you guys enjoyed this episode nonetheless. And again, thank you for all the nice comments and the wishful thinking about the trip to the doctor. And I'm trying to stay positive here, so I hope it's not bad. But again, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Peace out, Girl Scouts. Oh, by the way, I forgot. So, at the end of this video, what you guys are going to hear is a test recording of some audio, and some of you guys are aware, back in episode 75-ish, give or take 5, so 70 to 80, I did actually talk to you guys about doing a podcast. Now, I've actually learned a way to record Skype calls. And what I want you guys to do, it's only going to be like a 15-20 second video here. I want you guys to let me know whether or not the quality is bearable, and whether or not it needs to be turned up, turned down, whether or not there's background sound that needs to be focused on, you know, because I know some of us, such as myself, have a loud computer with a loud background noise, and I know how to get rid of it, but would like you guys to just to give me some, you know, constructive criticism about it. So and by the way, that's a big tip on being on the lookout for the Mindcrack podcast. All right, guys, peace out, Girl Scouts.
I got that song in my head, the intro song. Oh, did I finish downloading the Sniper intro? No, not yet.
Well, that's why your internet's probably crapping out. Can't handle the downloading.
No, I was doing it before I clicked that. It's better. It's all better now. Maybe it was just a little.
Actually, it's kind of weird. Skype takes up a lot of bandwidth.
Mm-hmm. I can't hold Skype calls.
What's going on?
What the hell, man? You about to restart your game.